Ypres to Arenberg Port de Hainaut, 155.5 kilometres. Stage 5 is the one that has put the fear into the riders aiming for the general classification. Starting in Ypres, the day is only 155 km long. However, 9 sections and 10% of that are made up of the fearsome cobbles of Paris Roubaix. Whilst the likes of Sepp van Marck and Cancellara will be licking their lips at the prospect of a stage win, Froome, Contador, Nibali, etc. will be desperate just to get to Arenberg unscathed and not having lost any time to their GT rivals. After a 15-minute neutral section, the race heads northeast through Belgium, skirting through Zonnebeke, Roeselare, where the race turns south, Ledigen, Wevelgem, Mouscron, and then over the border into France and the well-known town of Roubaix. At this point, they'll have covered 64 kilometres. This opening section of the stage is on roads which are generally wide, but sometimes exposed. The first big fight for position will start through the towns of Saint-Guinon-Menentoit and Bouvines, as they hurtle towards the first section of cobbles, the pavé de Grousson. In Paris-Roubaix, this straight 1.1 km section is only given a 2-star ranking, so it really serves as an hors d'oeuvre of what is to come. At the end of the section, the riders will have covered 88.5 kilometres. It won't just be the GC riders fighting it out for position at Grousson, but also the sprinters. The day's intermediate sprint is located just 8.5 km later on the outskirts of Templouve. Unlike other stages though, there won't be much time to relax after this sprint. The road continues to twist and turn towards Ennevelin, where the next sector will start. This 3-star section is 1400 metres long, and soon after they reach the end of it, they'll see the sign informing them there's 50 km remaining. From here, the cobbled sections come thick and fast. Section 7 is the Mons en Pavé, which, in Paris-Roubaix, is given the maximum 5-star rating. However, today the riders will only cover 1 kilometre of this section before heading back onto smooth roads. The tarmac only lasts 3.5 km though, before it is once again replaced by the rough stuff, this time on Section 6 at Bercy. From here, it's back onto bigger roads for a few Ks. Bouvry-la-Forêt is the next section, starting with exactly 30 km remaining. This was used in Paris-Roubaix for the first time in 2007, and is also known as the Section Marc Madiot, in honour of the Frenchman, now manager at FDJ, who twice won the race. Only 4 km separates them from the next section, which is 2.4 km in length. Given a 4-star rating in Paris-Roubaix, this is a testing section of the stage, incorporating many turns. There's grass growing down the middle of the road, whilst the dusty edges will offer some smoother respite for those willing to take the risk of riding there. At the end of this section, just 22 km remain until they reach the finish in Arenberg, but only 1.5 km to the next sector, the Brionne-Varlaine, which in itself is 1.4 km long. The penultimate sector at Wandigne is arguably the hardest of the day. It begins with 15.5 km to go, and it's 3.7 km in length. It was here at this year's Paris-Roubaix where Omega Pharma Quickstep made their first acceleration with Tom Bonin and eventual winner Nicky Terpstra. This sector was also used back in 2010, at the Tour de France the last time it visited the cobbles. With its proximity to the finish line, that team will be hoping to have strength in numbers as they attempt to take the stage win. By the end of this sector, we're likely to see the bunch in pieces, either due to crashes or simply the pace at the front. At Valère, with 6.5 km to go, the riders will start the final cobbled section of the day. 1.6 km in length, it is also a 3-star section in Paris-Roubaix. This last 8 km of the stage traces the same route as Stage 3 in 2010, where Tourischoff took the victory. And it's likely that today, when they reach Arenberg, we'll see an equally strong rider raise their arms aloft as stage winner.